check out Amanda, Universal Boxing Gym, that's a patriot, fellow Boricua, take hall number 5. How did that feel? You graced us a proud because not only come to the gym, but you go from your home country.
You know, it's amazing for, you know, to not only Latina, but Puerto Rican, what fighter, and losing a win on that. And I'm just very happy for her, and the first part of the gym,
I talked to Amanda early in the week, and I said, Porter never won 5, Tito never won 5, Benitez never won 5, Camacho never won 5, and you got great champions for that island.
Not one, but yeah. You know, it's amazing. She made history today. I'm proud of her. And there's more to come. You know, she got a lot of fire in her, a lot of fight. And hey, let's see. I believe 118 is a little low for her, but 120, 122, I think she's dominant. And
down for this, it was a little different for her to see, but it shows the hard work and dedication she put in with Jordan in the gym to make it happen. Plus, she heard that Universal Boxing Gym is 100 degrees. You split that way right off, right?
That's what I'm talking about, 100 degrees. It feels like you're in Puerto Rico and the island, but you're really extreme.
The heat, yeah, that's it, right there. Now, you're coming off a very impressive showing on Fox Sports. We see you fight a very good fighter, Sam Vasquez, and no disrespect to your opponent, but you put it on him. Question knockout.
You know, a lot of people have to lose in a fight. I always say don't count a wounded lion out until his last breath. Because he's going to be dangerous to that last breath. And, you know, I'm prepared mentally, physically, and emotionally ready for that fight 100%. And it shows. So now I just want this big fight. You know, they threw me in here as an opponent. And I came out victorious with not just a victory, but a
statement. Yeah.
And I'm just eager to get back. And the one I won, Danny Garcia.
So, yeah. Now, Danny Garcia got a little bit of, like, you know, through the boxing public. He got a kind of a reputation, maybe sometimes, I don't say it personally, because I don't believe so, but maybe some people will say he's trying to take easy fights. You think he's going to be Cherry Garcia and try to duck you, or you think he'll embrace that and make a Brooklyn Puerto Rican versus Philadelphia Puerto Rican fight that people will want to see?
You know, right now we both, I believe, not only Puerto Rican, but two of the best welterweights in the East Coast. It does make sense. You know, he's been fighting here at the Barclays. I'm from Brooklyn. We're both Puerto Rican, and we both got down the room. You know, he's coming off the loss from the Big Family. I'm coming off a victorious win off of Sammy Vasquez. I fought Keith Sammy. My fight got stopped due to the cuts. But the 6th rounds were competitive. And his fight was, I believe, Thurman won 9-3. And Danny was lost, but he don't gotta look for me. I'm gonna be right in his face, and that's the beauty of that fight.
Now, me personally, I thought Danny did actually very well in the Thurman fight. A lot of people didn't give him credit, but he was swiping the body good. He kept a good defense, and the second half of the fight was blocking a lot of shots. I thought he did very well. So I think that'll be a great fight. Another fight at welterweight, I know that I spoke to Adrian Corona last time he was over here. Is that another name, perhaps, that you'll be interested in a fight at 147?
Hey, that's what he wants. I'm willing to do it, but we got to be at 47. We can't be in the pathway because I can't make my foot. And I know he's been fighting in those weights, and that's the name, hey. Like you said, AB, anybody can get it. I'm with it.
Now, last question. We know that you're a big boxing fan, other than being a great boxer yourself. We have Canelo fighting Chavez next month. That should be very interesting. What's your take on that old Mexico matchup?
That's a very interesting fight. You know, Canelo moving up way faster. Chavez looks like he's really focused on this fight. You know, he's 6 miles. It's a fight for Mexico, basically. You know, a lot of pride and ego involved in this one. So, you know, it depends on Chavez shows up. If it's Chavez, this is a focus. He can be first off.
Give favor to Chavez because he's naturally a bigger guy, or give advantage to Canelo because he's maybe walking around at 168, coming down from 175 or 180.
I like Chavez. This is a decision. You just never know what boxing, man. It's a beauty of the sport. You can stop anytime, man. Anytime.
Listen, we appreciate your time, champ, and we hope to see you back in the ring very soon.
Thank you, dude.
God bless. Can we break up? My bad, I came a little late on the conversation. Danny Garcia, Keith Thurman fighter. Should I say Thurman Garcia? Did you see anything that you can possibly expose? Was he exposed?
Danny?
Danny, yes.
You know, not exposed, because, you know, I feel like every fight he had that fighter's moves, he had problems with. And with the Herrera fight, with the Peterson fight, and I'm sure Keith Thurman has a blueprint for that. Give a movement and throw Danny off.
Right. Now, speaking of Keith, he caught a lot of flack. You know, when you hurt him to the body, a lot of people were saying that he may have had a glass body. What do you think about that? He came back in the fight, he didn't go down, but you had him hurt. Do you think that he's vulnerable to the body?
You know what, let me tell you, man, the shot you don't see, those ones that really hurt. He was throwing a shot, I threw a shot, I landed clean. He's head, you know, if I would have never heard the 10-second count, I would have took a knee. But, you know, he stood up as a champ. I don't take nothing away from him.